Jacob's that star-spangled banner yet waved. Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Welcome out to Kossuth High School Baseball. Josh Longcar here as we get set for game two between the Aggies and Blue Devils of Booneville. Game was moved from tomorrow night till tonight to try to avoid the rain, and it is sprinkling right now. There's been a couple sprinkles during the JV game, and just got a few more right now. Hopefully everything will move out pretty soon, and we'll be in good shape, and I'll get my nerves out here. Lineup for the Blue Devils will be batting first, in the top of the first here. Batting first, number 9, Trey Miller. Batting second, number 7, Colin Fleury. Batting third, number 2, Jack Sandlin. Batting fourth, number 16, Sawyer Ritchie. Batting fifth, number 1, Clark Jansen. Batting sixth, number 23, Jacob Matthews. Batting 7th, number 26, Bryson Sailors. Batting 8th, number 10, Corbin White. And batting 9th, number 6, Riley Barnes. In the field for the Aggies, it will be Hunter Hutchins on the mound tonight for the Aggies. Behind the plate will be Bryson Jackson. At first base, Jake Allen. Second base, Rylan Henry. Third base, Eli Hinton. Shortstop, Aiden Wilbanks. Left field, Logan Williams. Center field, Reed Coward. And in right field, T.J. Oakman. So we'll get this game underway as Trey Miller will lead it off for the Blue Devils. Hunter Hutchins on the mound. Here's the windup in the first pitch. Miller thinks about a bunt, pulls it back though, and it's high and inside, ball 1 to Miller. Hutchins delivers again, low and away, ball 2. Here's the windup, pitch, and hits the strike zone. Strike 1. 2 balls, 1 strike now to Trey Miller. Hutchins looks in, gets his sign. Here's the pitch. Curveball hangs it a little bit, and it's hit to center field. Reed Cowell to run it down the left center to record the out. So with one down here in the top of the first, it'll be Colin Fleury up to bat. He had a single up the middle on a ground ball Tuesday night. That was a 9-2 victory for the Aggies. Here's the windup in the pitch, swing and a miss by Fleury. Strike 1. Hutchins, quick delivery again. High and away that time. Ball 1. Hutchins, quick on his wind up. Here's pitch. It's outside. Ball 2. 2 balls, 1 strike now to Fleury. Here's the wind up in the pitch. It's fouled back and out of play. 2 balls, 2 strikes now to Colin Fleury. Hunter Hutchins looks in, shakes one off, goes with his second option. Low and away, but called. Strike 3, and Fleury will go down looking. So 2 outs here in the top of the first. No score. Jack Sandlin up to bat now for Booneville. He's a left-handed batter. Hutchins in a windup. Here's the pitch. Inside. Called. Strike 1. Kind of hooked that ball back in there. Here's the windup in the pitch. Inside again. Oh, it hit him. Just got a piece of him. it wasn't bad enough that Bryson couldn't catch it. Bryson was able to squeeze it. So a hit-by-pitch with two outs will put Sandlin at first base and bring up Sawyer Ritchie to bat now against Hutchins. Here's the wind-up pitch. It'll be ball one. Hunter looks in, checks his runner at first. Here's the pitch. High swinging strike. Got him to chase that one. One ball, one strike now to Ritchie. Two outs, runner at first. In the stretch, he fouls that one off. One ball, two strikes. Hutchins, low, ball two. There's the pitch, got him on the outside. Strike three looking. So Hunter Hutchins gets two strikeouts in that first inning. And they'll strand one runner at first. So we'll go to the bottom of the first here at Kossuth. No score. Due up for, let's see, in the field for Booneville. It'll be Clark Jansen on the mound for the Blue Devils. Jacob Matthews will be catching. Jack Sandlin at first base. Corbin White at second. Colin Fleury at third. Trey Miller at short. Sawyer Ritchie in left. Riley Barnes in center. And Bryson Sailors in right field. The Aggies batting lineup. It'll be Rylan Henry leading it off for the Aggies. Batting second, number 21, T.J. Oakman. Batting third, D.H.ing tonight, number 6, Hank Eaton. Batting fourth, number 2, Aiden Wilbanks. Batting fifth, number 20, Eli Hinton. Batting sixth, number 24, Bryson Jackson. Batting seventh, number 3, Logan Williams. Batting eighth, number 10, Reed Coward. And batting ninth, number 14, Jake Allen. In a Tuesday night ball game, I think they had a total of maybe 5 errors in that ball game. The Aggies ended up with 3-2. Not a clean ball game by either team. So looking to clean it up here tonight. Jansen, a right-handed pitcher for the Blue Devils. Aggies' next scheduled ball game will be Saturday against Morville. I believe it might be a 2 o'clock ball game. So if you don't have anything much planned Saturday, it might be a good time to come to the field. Watch pretty good ball teams play. Rylan Henry to lead it off here for the Aggies in this bottom of the first. Rylan batting 327 on the year. Here's the windup and the pitch from Jansen. And Henry will look at strike one. Second pitch from Jansen. Swing and a miss. Rylan Henry. Jansen looks in, gets his sign. There's the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss by Henry. Chased that one outside. That's one down here in the bottom of the first. Number 21, T.J. Oakman up to bat now for the Aggies. Jansen looks in, gets his sign. Here's pitch number one. It's on the ground to the shortstop. Slow roller. Miller will charge it, get it, throw it across. Get there just in time to get open at first.
At the plate for the Aggies, your designated hitter, number six, Hank
Eaton. That'll bring up Hank Eaton now for the Aggies. With two outs here in the bottom of the first, no score. Jansen toes the rubber. Here's the windup. And the pitch. Low and outside corner. He'll hit for strike one. Jansen shakes off his first one, second one. Time asked for by Hank and Granite. Here's the windup and the pitch from Jansen. Low and outside. Ball one. One ball, one strike now to Hank Eaton with two outs here in the bottom of the first. No score. Here's the pitch. Hank will foul that one back out of play. One ball, two strikes now to Eaton with two outs here in the bottom of the first. Jansen looks in, gets his sign. Here's the pitch. Swing, gonna miss by Hank Eaton. And we'll go to the top of the second here in Kossuth. No score between the Aggies and Blue Devils. We'll take a break. We'll be back with more Aggie baseball in just a minute.
If you have been putting off rain gutters, now is the time. Hutchins Gutters is offering free estimates whether you need new gutters, your existing ones cleaned, or leaf guards installed. Give Randy Hutchins a call at 662-643-3905. That's Hutchins Gutters at 662-643-3905.
If you're out and about this evening, stop by your local area Subway, pick up a foot-long chips and a drink, and don't forget the cookies. Thanks to Arthur Enterprise for sponsoring the broadcast this year and all our local area Subway.
The enrollment period is now open at Shining Star Gymnastics, 303 Fleming Street in Corinth. Tanya Duffy at Shining Star Gymnastics, starting at 2 years old, offers recreational and tumbling classes, a competitive gymnastics team, and a competitive cheer team. Follow Shining Star Gymnastics on Facebook or call Tanya to sign your child up today. You can give Tanya a call at 662-284-7016.
Clark Jansen lead it off here for the Blue Devils in the top of the second. Hutchins back on the mound. Here's the windup and the pitch. It's on the ground to short at Wilbanks. He'll field it. Throw across is in time for the 6-3 put out. That'll bring up number 23, Jacob Matthews now for the Blue Devils. No score here in the top of the second. One out. Hutchins on the mound. Matthews at the plate. Here's the windup and the pitch. It's in there for strike one. Hutchins working quick. Here's his second pitch. This is a breaking pitch. Swung on and missed for strike two. Hutchins to the plate again. Swing and a miss. Strike three. So Matthews goes down on strikes. That's one, two, three strikeouts so far for Hunter Hutchins. Two outs here in the top of the second. No score. Bryson Saylor is up to bat now for the Blue Devils. Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch inside. Ball one. Saylor is a left-handed batter. That pitch is toward the third baseline. Hinton will grab it. Throw across is in time. Good job by Eli Hinton. Tried to hit the replay on that. Let's see if I can get it to play here real quick. 5-3 put out. Let me see. Oh, I don't have it. So no scores. We go to the bottom of the second. Due up for the Aggies. It'll be 4, 5, and 6. Will Banks, Hinton, and Jackson. We'll take a break. We'll be back with more Aggie baseball in just a minute.
Nikki Shaw at Crossroads Cleaning and Disinfecting is a proud sponsor of the Kossuth Aggies and this broadcast. Give Nikki Shaw a call for all your cleaning and disinfectant needs. He'd be glad to give you a
There's the wind up in the pitch. Low. Ball one. Here's a pitch from Jansen. Checked out. And they're going to check with the first base ump, and they're going to say he went. So one ball, two strikes now to Eli Hinton. Jansen. In the windup. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss by Eli. Strike three. Three strikeouts now for Jansen. Bryson Jackson coming to the plate now for Kossuth. Jansen. Looks inside. Gets his sign. Here's the windup and the pitch. Bryson will foul that one back. Jansen and the windup. Here's the pitch. Low and away. Ball one. One ball, one strike, two outs here in the bottom of the second. Jansen in the windup. Here's the pitch. Bryson will foul that one to the right and out of play. So Bryson in the hole, one ball, two strikes now. Jansen looks in, gets his sign. Here's the windup and the pitch. Bryson gets a hold of that one to left field, and it's fair. It'll go all the way to the corner. He'll round first and be standing up with a double. So Bryson Jackson. With a double to get the Aggies a runner on base. Now bring up Logan Williams. I'll get a courtesy runner, Trey Arthur. Will come in to run for Bryson. Logan Williams at the plate now with two outs. Arthur will be running for Jackson at second. We're in the bottom of the second with no score. Jansen checks Arthur at second. Here's the pitch. Low. Ball one. Matthews will go out to talk to Jansen. Probably change up their signs with the runner at second here. One ball, no strikes to Logan Williams. Jansen looks in, gets his sign. Here's the windup and the pitch. Logan takes that ball to center field. Center fielder's back, and he'll make the catch. And that'll be the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, one man left on base. No scores. We go to the top of the third, due up for the Blue Devils. It'll be 8-9-1. White, Barnes, and Miller due up to bat for the Blue Devils. We'll take a break. We'll be back with more Aggie baseball in just a minute.
Spencer Electric, voted Best of the Crossroads in 2023, are your go-to electricians for all commercial and residential projects. They are licensed, bonded, and insured, serving Corinth and surrounding areas. Give Alan Spencer a call at 662-665-1027. That's Alan Spencer over at Spencer Electric.
Moore's Chrome Tire Center, 3106 Highway 72 West in Corinth, is an authorized dealer of Goodyear tires. Moore's and the staff can handle most of your car mechanical needs, from tire, oil change, brakes, and front end alignments. Roadside assistance is also available. Give them a call at 662-286-3826. Moore's Chrome Tire Center is a proud sponsor of the Kossuth Aggies.
Welcome back to Kossuth High School. Josh Longcar here as we get set for the top of the third. No score between the Blue Devils and Aggies. Hunter Hutchins on the mound for Kossuth. At the plate will be Corbin White. Hutchins shakes off his first one, likes his second. Here's the pitch outside. Ball one. Here's the windup in the pitch from Hutchins. It'll be hit toward right field, and it's into the bullpen, out of play. One ball, one strike now to Corbin White. Hutchins looks in, gets his sign. He's trying to work quick. Here's pitch low. Bryce will block it up, keep it in front of him. Two balls, one strike now to White. Here's the windup. Hutchins looks in, gets a sign. Here's wind up in the pitch. It's on the ground back to Hunter. He'll knock it down, pick it up, throw across Allen, and then record out number one. So one out here in the top of the third, no score. Riley Barnes up to bat now for the Blue Devils. Hunter looks in, gets a sign. Here's the windup. He'll square around, try to bunt. It's pulled back. It'll be low, ball one. Hunter looks at the bunt again from Barnes. It'll go foul for strike one. So one ball, one strike to Riley Barnes. Hunter Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch. He'll square around again, pull back, and get hit. So another hit-by-pitch will put a runner at first with one out here in the top of third. No score. Little high. Ball one. Hunter in the stretch. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss by Miller. One ball, one strike now. Hunter looks in, gets his sign again. Here's the pitch. Low and away. It'll go off the foot of the umpire. Bryce will run it down. So the runner will advance to second. One out. 2-1 count now to Miller. Here's the pitch. Breaking pitch drops in there. Must have been outside. Ball three. Three balls, one strike now to Miller. Hutchins delivers again low. That'll be ball four. And Miller will go to first. Bryson tried to throw down to center, not in time. Runner's back safely. So runner at first and second now here in the top of the third. One out. Bryson will go out to talk to Hunter. Two seniors talk it over. And bring up Colin Fleury. He struck out looking his first time up. Hutchins in the stretch. Here's the pitch. Fleury drives it to center field, right on the screws to Reed Coward. Reed will get it in quick, and everybody will hold up. Just a hard hit ball, but it went straight to Reed Coward. So two outs here in the top of third, no score. Jack Sandlin up to bat now with runners at first and second. Hunter Hutchins, first pitch, low and away. Bryson Jackson will block it up. Ball one. Here's the wind up in the pitch. It went off the bat. So it'll be a foul ball. So one ball, one strike. Hunter Hutchins looks in, gets a sign, shakes off the first, locks the second. He'll come to the plate now. In there for a strike two. Just right on the bottom outside corner of the strike zone. Hunter looks in, gets a sign. Here's the pitch. He's hit toward left field. Williams is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. No runs, no hits, no errors. Two men left on base for the Blue Devils that inning. Do up for the Aggies in the bottom of the third. It'll be 8-9-1. Reed Coward, Jake Allen, and Rylan Henry do up to bat. We'll take a break. We'll be back with more Aggie baseball in just a minute.
With summer right around the corner, and warm temperatures approaching fast, it's time to spruce those flower beds up. Hunter Eaton at Grounds Crew can handle the job. Grounds Crew will build any kind of backyard fence. Get on the schedule for yard maintenance with Hunter Eaton at Grounds Crew, 662-808-3011. Wade Incorporated is your John Deere dealer for Corinth, Mississippi. Go by and see Jackson Blaine Mitchell for all your small agriculture needs. Lawn mowers, small tractors, any kind of attachment that you might could think of. If he doesn't have it on the yard, he can find it for you. Go by and see Jackson, or you can give him a call at 662-392-6659. That's 662-392-6659. That's Jackson Blaine Mitchell over at Wade Incorporated.
Welcome back to Kossuth High School. Josh Longcar here as we get set for the bottom of the third. No score here between the Blue Devils and Aggies. Reed Coward will lead it off for the Aggies. Clark Jansen back to the mound. He's thrown 24 pitches through two innings of work. Jansen looks in, gets his sign. Here's the windup in the pitch. And Coward will foul that off to the right. Out of play. Strike one. Jansen looks in. Here's the windup in the pitch. Low. Ball one. One ball, one strike now. One ball, two strikes now to Reed Coward. Jansen looks in, gets a sign. Here's the windup and the pitch. Reed hits that one to the shortstop. He'll take it off the chest. And Reed will be aboard with an E6. He was down on the ball, but took a hop and came right up in his chest and hit him. Bounces over towards second base. So E6 will put Reed Coward at first base and bring up Jake Allen with nobody out here in the bottom of the third. No score. Jansen in the stretch now. He'll check back toward first, throw that way, pick back that way, and Reed's back safely. Jansen throws the rubber again in the stretch. Checks Allen at first. Comes set. Here's the pitch, high, ball one. One ball, no strikes now to Jake Allen. He'll look down toward first to get the sign from Coach Lathrop. Pick back to first, Reed's back safely. Jansen in the stretch. Allen squares round, fouls it off. And catcher took the worst end of that. So the umpire, Mr. Smith, gives the young man his second to recover. Goes out and talks to Jansen. We'll get set to go again. One ball, one strike now to Jake Allen. Runner at first, nobody out. Reed gets his lead. Jansen goes back to first to pick it. Reed's back safely. Jansen looks in again to get his sign. Checks Reed at first. He'll come to the plate now. Reed goes. Allen tries to bunt it. Can't get it down. And Reed will get second on the trying to hit and run there. So Reed goes down to second with a stolen base. Jake Allen at the plate with a one ball, two strike count. Jansen Looks in, gets his sign. He'll check Howard at second. He'll come to the plate now. Swing and a miss. Might have fouled Tifty. He did. But Matthew's able to squeeze it for out number one. So one out here in the bottom of the third. No score. Reed Coward at second base. We're back around with the leadoff man, Rylan Henry. He struck out swinging his first time up. Jansen comes set. Here's the pitch. Rylan fouls that one back to the screen. So Rylan in a hole now. No balls, two strikes. Jansen checks the runner at second and comes to the plate now. Outside, ball one. Couldn't get Rylan to chase there. So one ball, two strikes now to Rylan Henry. Here's the pitch high, ball two. Two balls, two strikes. Jansen comes to the plate, high, ball three. So Rylan battles back in there with the full count now. With Reed Coward at second base, one out. Jansen looks in to get his sign. First time up. Jansen looks in to get his sign. Comes to the plate now. High. Ball one. Jansen to the plate. Swing and a miss by Oakman. Strike one. One ball, one strike now to T.J. Oakman. Two outs here in the bottom of the third. Reed Coward at second base. T.J. with a chance here. Pitch inside, called strike two. One ball, two strikes now. One ball, two strikes. Jansen comes set. Here's the pitch. High, ball two. Two balls, one strike now to T.J. Oakman with two outs. Reed Coward at second base. Here's the pitch outside. Ball three. So full count now to T.J. Oakman. Jansen in the stretch, comes set. Here's the pitch. T.J. hits that one high towards center field. Center fielder is there, and he'll make the catch. So no runs, no hits, one error, one man left on base for the Aggies in that inning. We'll go to the top of the fourth here at Kossuth. No score due up for the Blue Devils. It'll be 4, 5, and 6. Sawyer Ritchie, Clark Jansen, and Jacob Matthews due up to bat. We'll take a break. We'll be back with more Aggie baseball in just a minute.
Anchor Rehabilitation is your choice for therapy services. We offer pediatric and adult, physical, occupational, speech, and behavioral therapy. Whether you've undergone a recent surgery, suffer from muscle or joint pain, or your pediatrician feels like your child would benefit from therapy services, please give us a call at 662-643-4043 Our friendly therapists hold certifications in feeding therapy, dry needling, sensory integration, behavioral disorders, hand therapy, and vestibular rehab. We at Anchor want to wish the Aggies a safe and successful season. Go Aggies!
Welcome back to Kossuth High School. Josh Longcar here as we get set for the top of the fourth between the Blue Devils and Aggies. It will be Sawyer Ritchie to lead it off here for the Blue Devils. He struck out looking his first time out. Hunter Hutchins back to the mound for Kossuth. Here's the windup and the pitch from Hunter. It'll be called strike one. Hunter in a windup. Here's the pitch. Now it's hit toward right field. Oakman's tracking it. He's there, and he'll make the catch. So two pitches in and out. Clark Jansen up to bat now. Clark grounded out to Aiden Wilbanks. It's short. His first time up. One out here in the top of the fourth. No score. Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch low. Bryson will block it up. Ball one. Hutchins looks in, gets his sign. Here's the windup and the pitch. Breaking pitch drops in there for a called strike. One ball, one strike now to Jansen. Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch outside. Ball two. Two balls, one strike now to Jansen. There's another breaking pitch, and Jansen will just get a bat on it. Hutchins will field it, toss it to Allen, and they'll get the out. I believe that's Hunter's second put out. Assist. Jacob Matthews to the plate now with two outs here in the top of the fourth. No score. Matthews struck out swinging his first time up. Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch. And they'll get the call on the outside. Strike one. Here's the windup and the pitch from Hutchins. Outside a little bit further that time. Ball one. Hunter in the windup. Here. Two outs here in the top of the fourth. No score. Hutchins. And the windup, here's the pitch. It's a fly ball on out toward right field. Oakman is there, and he'll get it. So TJ Oakman with a can of corn. And that'll retire the Blue Devils. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth with no score here in Kossuth. Threw up for the Aggies. It'll be 3, 4, and 5. Hank Eaton, Aiden Wilbanks, and Eli Hinton do up to bat. We'll take a break. We'll be back with more Aggie baseball in just a minute.
Song you're wanting to perform at church, more than likely, Gary and Donna and the staff at New Life can get it for you. Give them a call at 662-287-5885 or stop by and take a look around. New Life Christian Supply on South Harbor Road, just 1 mile from the Walmart Supercenter.
Although retirement seems far away, you'll want to retire at some point. Unfortunately, that nest egg won't build itself. Remember, the sooner you start to save, the more time your money has to grow. Modern Woodmen can help you plan for all stages of life, from protection to saving to retirement.
I want to say thanks to Michael and Micah Kilo for sponsoring the broadcast this year. They are distributors of Pepperidge Farm products, Mission Tortilla products. Those products can be found at all your local area grocery stores, Walmart, Kroger, Gardner's, Rogers, Shiloh Market. Help support them because they help support us. Thanks to Michael and Micah for sponsoring the broadcast this year. Leading it all for the Aggies here in the bottom of the fourth with no score against the Booneville Blue. Clark Jansen on the mound has worked three complete innings. He's thrown 45 pitches, 30 strikes, 15 balls. Clark checks with his infield, makes sure everybody's set. He'll come back to the mound. He'll look in, get his sign. Here's the windup and the pitch. Hank looks at ball one. Here's the windup and the pitch. And that drops in there for a strike. One ball, one strike now to Eaton. Jansen in the windup. Here's the pitch. High and inside. Ball two. Two balls, one strike now to Hank Eaton. Here's the windup and the pitch from Jansen. That goes across for strike two. Two balls, two strikes now. Jansen in the windup. Here's the pitch. High, ball three. Full count now to Hank Eaton. Jansen looks in, gets a sign. Here's the windup and the pitch inside. Ball four. That'll put Hank down at first on the walk. So the leadoff man gets on. It'll bring up Aiden Wilbanks to the plate. Aiden flew out to center field his first time up. No score here in the bottom of the fourth. Nobody out. Hank Eaton at first base. Jansen in the stretch. He'll check on Eaton. He'll come to the plate. Wilbanks swings and misses. Ball gets away from the catcher. Goes to the backstop. And Eaton will advance to second on the pass ball. So runner at second. Nobody out. No balls. One strike now to Wilbanks. High. Ball one. One ball, one strike to Aiden Wilbanks. Jansen will look in and get his sign. He'll check on Eaton. He'll come to the plate. Swing and a miss by Wilbanks. For strike two. One ball, two strikes. Nobody out. Hank Eaton at second base. Jansen comes to the plate. Wilbanks fly ball out towards center field. It's deep. Center fielder is there. As he's backing up, he'll make the catch. He'll relay it in, but Hank will easily tag up and make it to second. Just shy of the wall that ball was. Center fielder had his momentum going back when he made the catch, so couldn't get it in too quick. So Eli Hinton up with one out. Hank Eaton second base. Here's the windup and the pitch from Jansen. And Eli will foul it back to the net for strike one. No score here in the bottom of the fourth. One out. Hank Eaton at third base. Here's the windup and the pitch high. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Jansen looks in, gets a sign. Here's the pitch. Eli, hard hit in the infield in, and he'll get past Miller at short. And that'll score a run for the Aggies. So Eli Hinton with the RBI single will bring Hank Eaton across on a hard hit ground ball to left field. So the Aggies get on the board first to make it 1-0 here in the bottom of the fourth. Bryson Jackson up to bat. Bryson had a double to left field his first time up. Jansen comes to the plate. Hits it high on the, in the infield. First baseman is there, and he'll make the catch. So that'll be two outs. Now here in the bottom of the fourth, the Aggies lead 1-0. Logan Williams up to bat. Eli Hinton at first base. Logan Williams at the plate. Jansen on the mound. Here's the pitch. Logan takes that ball to center field. Shallow center field. And second baseman is there. Is that the second baseman that caught it? So the second baseman, Corbin White, goes all the way out to make that catch in shallow center field. So the Aggies get one run, one hit, no errors, one man left on base. To make it 1-0 as we go to the top of the fifth here in Kossuth, due up for the Blue Devils. It'll be 7-8-9, Bryson Sailors, Corbin White, and Riley Barnes due up to bat. We'll take a break. We'll be back with more Aggie baseball in just a minute.
SCP Polymers, located in Booneville, Mississippi, would like to wish the Kossuth good luck this season. SCP Polymers specializes in custom thermoplastic injection molded parts. Ask us about free tooling for high volume parts. Give us a call at 662-728-9506. SCP Polymers, proud sponsors of the Kossuth Aggies.
Welcome back to Kossuth High School. Josh Longcar here as we get set for the top of the fifth here in Kossuth. Hunter Hutchins back to the mound for the Aggies. He has thrown 51 total pitches. He's faced through four innings, faced 15 batters, 31 strikes, 20 balls. He has three, walked one, and hit two. Number 26, Bryson Sailors, will lead it all for the Blue Devils here to get this top of the fifth underway here at Kossuth. Hunter Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch, low. And it'll get past Bryson all the way to the backstop. For ball one. Hutchins comes to the plate. That ball's hit towards second base. Henry will field it, throw it across, be in time for the 4-3 put out. So one out here in the top of fifth. The Aggies lead 1-0. Corbin White up to bat. He grounded out to the pitcher his first time up. Hunter Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch. And he'll catch the bottom of the strike zone for strike one. That's a breaking pitch. It'll drop in. White will bounce it towards second. Ryan will field it. Throw across for another 4-3 put out. So two away here in the top of the fifth. The Aggies leading 1-0. Riley Barnes up to bat. He was hit by a pitch his first time up. Here's the windup in the pitch. That ball's hit to center, to back of the infield. And Ryland will run that one down to make the catch. So Ryland was involved in every single out on that inning. Assisted in two and put out the third. So we'll go to the bottom of the fifth here at Kossuth. The Aggies lead 1-0 over the Blue Devils. Do up for the Aggies. It'll be 8-9-1. Reed Coward, Jake Allen, Ryland Henry do up to bat for the Aggies. Clark Jansen back to the mound for the Blue Devils. Clark, four complete innings. Faced 16 batters, threw 60 pitches, 39 strikes, 21 balls. He's given up one run. It was an earned run. He has struck out five, walked one. And that's it. So the Aggies with a 1-0 lead over the Blue Devils. Here's we go into the bottom of the fifth here at Kossuth. Saturday will be the next ball game, scheduled ball game for the Aggies, and it will be the Morville Troopers coming to town. Aggies and Troopers played earlier in the season. The Aggies were able to get the win down at Morville Look to keep it going. The Saturday ball game. I believe it's a 2 o'clock first pitch. So if you get an opportunity to come out Saturday afternoon and watch some baseball, it'd be a good time to do that. Two of the top teams in the north in Mississippi.
Moving on, bottom of the fifth for the Yankees. Your center fielder, number 10, Green Coward.
So 1-0, the Yankees would lead as we go to the bottom of the fifth. Reed Coward leaded off for Kossuth. He reached on an error by Trey Miller at shortstop his first time up. Jansen comes to the mound, kicks the dirt off the rubber, toes it, looks in. Here's the first pitch to Coward. It's short, ball one. Jansen in the windup, here's the pitch, high, right at the head. Coward, he's able to duck away from it, though. Two balls, no strikes. Here's the windup in the pitch. It's at him again. Reed ducks another one. So three balls, no strikes. In the windup, here's the pitch. That'll be a cross for strike one. Reed taking all the weight. Three balls, one strike now to Coward. Here's the windup in the pitch from Jansen. It's inside. Ball four. So Reed will be aboard again for the Aggies. Jake Allen up to bat. He struck out. Foul tip caught by the catcher his first time up. 1-0, the Aggies with the lead in the bottom of the fifth here at Kossuth. Nobody out, Reed Coward at first base. Jansen picks back to first. Coward didn't have much of a lead. Just trying to catch him sleeping over there. Jansen picks again. Coward's back safely. Coward gets his lead again. Allen squares around, bunts it, foul toward the first base dugout. No balls, one strike now to Jake Allen with Reed Coward at first base. Nobody out. Pick back to first. Coward is back safely. Jansen looks in, gets his sign, checks his runner at first. In the stretch, gets set. Here's the pitch. Coward goes. Allen fouls it back to the net for strike two. No balls, two strikes now to Jake Allen. Jansen checks on Coward again at first. Comes to the plate now. Allen, swing and a miss. Strike three.
On base for the Aggies, your second baseman, number four,
Rylan Henry back up to bat now. The leadoff man for the Aggies with one out here in the bottom of the fifth. The Aggies lead 1-0. Reed Coward at first base. He struck out twice in the ballgame. Jansen looks in to get his sign. Checks on Coward, picks back to him. Reed is back safely. Jansen checks the runner again, comes to the plate. Reed goes. It's a good throw down. Miller gets it and tags Coward at second base, and Reed will be caught stealing. One ball. No strikes to Henry now. Ryan will swing for strike one. One ball, one strike now with two outs here in the bottom of the fifth. The Aggies lead 1-0. Jansen in the windup. Comes to the plate. Ryland takes that one center field. Center fielder is there. And Barnes will make the catch for out number three. So we'll go to the top of the sixth here in Kossuth. The Aggies with a 1-0. Devils do up for the Blue Devils. It'll be the top of the lineup, 1, 2, and 3. Trey Miller, Colin Fleury, and Jack Sandlin up to bat. Hunter Hutchins back to the mound for the Aggies. Hunter has pitched 5 complete innings. He's faced 18 batters, threw 56 total pitches, 35 strikes, 21 balls. He has struck out 3. Walked 1 and hit 2. Six ground outs and 6 fly outs. I believe is, would that be right? That's 12 outs. He struck out 3. So they'll throw down and we'll get this top of the 6 underway here at Kossuth. The Aggies with a 1-0 lead. Trade it off here for the Blue Devils. Hutchins looks in, gets it signed from Jackson. Here's the windup and the pitch a little bit high, ball 1. Hunter in the windup. Here's the pitch. That ball will come up short. Ball 2. 2 balls, no strikes. There's a pitch down the middle for strike 1. Miller acted like he was going to try to bunt it. Pulled back, though. Hutchins. In high and inside. Ball 3. 3 balls, 1 strike now to Trey Miller. Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch. He'll foul that one off the mask of Bryson Jackson. Back to the backstop. Full count now to Miller. Hunter Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch. He'll foul that one back. This will be the 7th pitch of this at bat to Miller. Full count. Hunter Hutchins looks in, gets his sign. Here's the windup and the pitch. It'll be hit out to right field, and it'll drop for a base hit. So Trey Miller will be down with the base hit to right field. That'll bring up Colin Fleury now. And he's with a 1-0 lead. Here in the top of the 6th. That pitch is low. Ball 1. Hutchins checks his runner at first. Comes to the plate now. Inside again. Ball 2. Bryson will go out to talk to Hunter. Two balls, no strikes now to Colin Fleury. He has struck out looking and flew out to center field his last time up. Here's the pitch. Hard hit ball to the left side, and it's fair down the left field line. It's going all the way to the corner. Miller is rounding third. He's heading home, and he'll be in safely. So Colin Fleury with an RBI double down the left field line on a hard hit ground ball. That'll tie the ball game up at one apiece now here in the top of the sixth. I think it was a ground rule double. It must have went under the fence or something. And they're going to, Coach Lathrop is not one Miller to get three bases on the play. That's one spot on this field that I absolutely cannot see and never have been able to see. It must have went under the fence or something over there in left field. But Miller, if Miller was around third, but if he was already rounding, nope, they're going to bring him back no matter what. So they'll bring Miller back to third. On the ground rule double. So that'll take a run off the board. First pitch to Sandlin is a ball. Nobody out here in the top of the six. 1-0 the Aggies with the lead. That ball's hit toward first. Allen is up. He'll make the play. Touch first. Go to the third. Go to the plate. And they will call Miller safe. He swam around the tag of Bryson Jackson right at the plate. Man, that was a close play. Runner will stay at second, though. Colin Fleury will. So one out, ball game tied at one. Sawyer Ricci at the plate with a runner at second, one out. Curveball's outside, breaking pitches outside. Hutchins comes to the plate short. They throw down to the second. Fleury is back safely, though. Two balls, no strikes. Hutchins in the stretch. Checks his runner at second. Comes to the plate now. That ball's hit to first again. Allen will field it. Step on first. Fleury will advance. Third. So a runner at third with two outs. Score tied at one run apiece here in the top of the sixth. Clark Jansen up to bat. He's grounded out to short and to the pitcher so far in the ballgame. Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch. That ball's hit to right, and it's going to be foul. Just kept on curving out there. Tried to go the opposite way with it. Two outs here in the top of the sixth. Runner at third base. Score tied at one run apiece. Hutchins delivers ball one. Low and away, I guess. Hutchins comes to the plate and pitches outside. Ball two. Here's the pitch. That breaking pitch drops in just low. Ball three. Hutchins takes a deep breath. Here's the pitch. High, ball four. So he'll put Jansen aboard with two outs. Runners at first and third now. Here in the top of the sixth. Score tie, one run apiece. Looks like we'll get a courtesy runner for Jansen, number eight. That is Kyson Livingston. Will come in to run for Jansen. Coach Lathrop will come to the mound to talk to his infield. Score Score tied at one run apiece. Two outs here in the top of the sixth. Hunter trying to get out of this inning. Jacob Matthews up to bat now with the runners at first and third. Two outs. Hutchins in the stretch. Here's the pitch. That ball's hit toward right field. And Oakman can't make the catch. It'll hit the wall. Another run will come across. Second run will come across, and Blue Devils are up. 3-1. Curtis hit runner for Matthews. Number three will come in to run. Porter Tapp. There's a hard hit fly ball to right center. TJ just couldn't get there to it. It's 3-1 now with the runner at second with two outs. Hutchins comes to the plate. Breaking pitch outside. Ball one. Hunter takes a deep breath. Here's the pitch. It's inside, ball two. 3-1, the Blue Devils with the lead with two outs here into the top of the sixth. Here's the pitch. Called strike one. Bryson tries to throw down again. Get the runner at second. He's back safely, though. Hutchins comes to the plate. Here's a pitch, ground ball to the left side. It'll go through. They're sending him home. They'll throw to Bryson. Bryson will have him and tag him out at home. Little contact at home plate. Didn't try to slide. Coach Lathrop didn't like that at all. He gave Bryson a good push. Good throw in. Logan Williams. So Booneville. Three runs, four hits, no errors, one man left on base. They'll go ahead 3-1. We go to the bottom of the sixth here at Kossuth. Aggies trail the Blue Devils. Up for the Aggies, it'll be 2, 3, and 4. TJ Oakman, Hank Eaton, and Aiden Wilbanks do up to bat for the Aggies. Clark Jansen back to the mound for the Blue Devils. He's thrown 71 total pitches, 45 strikes, 26 balls. TJ Oakman trying to get things going. Got to get the bats going here tonight. Jansen in the windup. Here's the pitch. TJ squares around, pulls back. That's ball one on the high pitch. T. TJ squares around again, pulls it back. Ball two. He looks down to Coach Lathrop. Get the call. Jansen looks in. TJ squares around again. Pulls back, and he'll look at strike one that time. So two balls, one strike now to TJ Oakland. Off here in the bottom of the sixth, the Aggies trail 3-1. Here's the pitch. Call it strike two. Two balls, two strikes. Now to TJ Oakland. Two balls, two strikes. Nobody out here in the bottom of six. Jansen comes to the plate. Oakman takes that one off his elbow. So he'll get aboard with a hit by pitch. So runner at first. Nobody out. Hank Eaton up to bat now for the Yankees. Hank walked his last time up. Coach from Booneville come talk to the umpire. TJ Oakman at first base. Nobody out. Hank Eaton at the plate. Jansen on the mound. In the stretch. He'll check Oakman at first. Come set. Here's the pitch. Jansen will check the runner first again. He'll come to the plate. Hank takes that one deep to left field. And it's going to be forevermore out of this park. Hank Eaton with a two-run home run will tie this ball game for the Aggies. Three to three, just like. That ball got out of here in a hurry to left field. So nobody out. Two-run home run ties this ball game. Here's the pitch to Wilbanks. He'll drive it to right field. It's at the wall. Out of here. Back-to-back home runs by the Aggies. We'll put them ahead. 4-3. That one went to right field. Oh, come on, phone. So Aiden Wilbanks puts the Aggies ahead. Four to three. That's Aiden. I'm trying to send these pictures. Carry. Second one is Hank. So just like that, the Aggies, a hit by pitch on Oakman. Hank Eaton with a two-run home run to left field. And then the next pitch, I guess, was Aiden Wilbanks. He drives it all the way to right field for a home run. Yeah. First pitch into Eli Hinton. The called strike one. Second pitch to Hinton is called strike two. Third pitch, high, ball one. One ball, two strikes. Now to Eli Hinton. Here's the pitch, swing and a miss by Hinton. That'll be out number one now for the Aggies here in the bottom of six. They lead 4-3. Bryson Jackson up to bat. Bryson has a double, and he popped up on the infield his last time up. High pitch to start Bryson off. One ball, no strikes. Pitch number two, high, ball two. So two balls, no strikes now to Bryson Jackson. The Aggies ahead 4-3 here in the bottom of the sixth with one out. Here's the windup and the pitch. Bryson fouls that one back for strike one. Two balls, one strike now to Bryson Jackson. Jansen looks in, gets his sign. Here's the windup and the pitch. Bryson swings, misses. Big swing there by Bryson. So two balls, two strikes now on Bryson Jackson with one out here in the bottom of the sixth. The Aggies lead 4-3. Jansen looks in, gets a sign. Here's a little check at it. Leave it alone, no. Ball three. Three balls, two strikes. Full count now. Low, ball four. So Bryson will go down on the walk to first base with one out here in the bottom of the sixth. The Aggies lead 4-3. Logan Williams at the plate. Here's the pitch high, ball one. That's 90 total pitches now for Clark Jansen. One-oh count. Here's the pitch. Logan fouls that one back. Strike one. One ball, one strike. Bottom of the sixth. Runner at first is Bryson Jackson. The Aggies lead 4-3. Jansen comes set. Here's the pitch high. Ball two. Two balls, one strike now to Logan Williams. Clark Jansen checks the runner at first. Comes set. Here's the pitch. Logan fouls that one back. Two balls, two strikes now. Bryson Jackson at first base. Logan Williams at the plate. Here's the pitch. Logan takes that one over to the football field, out of play. Two-two count now to Logan Williams. J- Jansen in the stretch. Here's the pitch. Outside and low. Ball three. So a full count now to Logan Williams at the plate with one out. Runner at first is Bryson Jackson. Jansen checks the runner at first. Comes to the plate. Swing and a miss by Williams. He'll go down on strikes. So two outs. I'll get a courtesy runner for Bryson now with two outs. Trey Arthur will come in to run for him. The bat now. Reed is 0 for 1. Reached on an error and walked his last time up. Two outs here in the bottom of the sixth. The Aggies lead 4-3. First, and Arthur is back safely. Jansen checks Arthur at first again. He'll pick back to him, and he's back safely. He had a pretty good lead there. Jansen checks Arthur twice. Comes set. Comes to the plate now. Reed fouls that one back. No balls, one strike. Go, buddy. To Reed Coward. Trey Arthur running for Bryson Jackson at first with two outs here in the bottom of the sixth. The Aggies lead 4-3. Here's the pitch. Reed thought about it. Held up. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Now to Reed Coward. They pick back to Arthur at first. He's back safe. Jansen checks Arthur again at first. Comes set. Comes to the plate low and away. It'll get away from the catcher. And Trey Arthur will advance to second on the pass ball. So Trey Arthur at second base with two outs here in the bottom of the sixth. The Aggies lead 4-3. They have somebody in the bullpen. They want somebody to go out and stand watch as the catcher is out there. So a 2-1 count now to Reed Coward. Trey Arthur at second base. Two outs. Here's the pitch. Reed fouls that off to the right. Out of play. 2-2 count now. Two balls, two strikes. Trey Arthur at second. Jansen comes set. Here's the pitch. Reed fouls that one back. Trying to stay alive with a 2-2 count. Jansen comes set. Here's the pitch. Reed gets a hold of that to the right field. It's down. It's fair. Arthur around third. Reed will round first, heading to second, and Reed will get an RBI double. Put the Aggies up 5-3. Just a good hard hit ball to right field. And that'll be 102 pitches now for Clark Jansen, and the coach from Booneville will come back out, and I think this is his second trip this inning, so he has to make a change. I believe he will. Yep. He's going to take the ball from Jansen. Good game by Jansen, though. Pitched a heck of a ball game. Two outs, bottom of the sixth. The Aggies. Scored four runs this inning. Trying to get a number on the new pitcher here. Yes, it is number 20. That is Bennett Gino. Be the new pitcher for the Blue Devils. 5-3. The Aggies were trailing at the start of this bottom of the sixth. 3-1. TJ Oakman got hit by a pitch to be on first base. Advanced over to second. And Hank Eaton put it deep over the left field wall for a two-run home run to put the Aggies tied with the Blue Devils. And the next at bat was Aiden Wilbanks. He took it to right center, deep over the fence for a home run to make it 4-3. And then Reed Coward with a double to right field with an RBI double to make it 5-3 so far in this inning. Gino gets his warm-up pitches in. Be at the plate for the Aggies. Gino on the mound. Reed Coward at second. Here's the pitch, curveball up high, called strike one to Allen. It's in the stretch, here's the pitch. That's a curveball low, or breaking pitch low at the same time. Ball one. Gino checks the runner at second, comes to the plate now. That's outside, ball two. Two balls, one strike now to Jake Allen. Jake has Reed Coward at second base with two outs here in the bottom of the sixth. The Aggies lead 5-3. Gino checks Coward at second, comes to the plate now. Allen watches that one low, ball three. Three balls, one strike. Gino, the pitch, the ball's hit to short. Miller boots it. Coward around second, and he'll come in for the run. Sliding in at second, not in time. Jake Allen will be thrown out as catcher Matthews throws down and gets him at second base. Error by the shortstop. Scores Coward, and then Jake Allen will be tagged out. So the agony, three hits, one error, nobody left on base to make it 6-3. As we go to the top of the seventh, Hunter Hutchins will come back to try to close this ball game out. He has thrown 81 total pitches, 46 strikes, 35 balls. It will be 8-9-1 due up to bat for Booneville. Corbin White, Riley Barnes, and Trey Miller coming up to bat for Booneville. So Hunter Hutchins trying to close this ball game out for the Aggies. He's in the windup. Here's the pitch. Swing and miss by White. Strike one. Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch. Outside. Ball one. Here's the windup and the pitch from Hutchins. Breaking pitch. It'll be softly hit to first base. Tag Jake Allen will field it and tag the runner. This is kind of one of those in between. Hunter not going to get there in time to get White, but Jake Allen fields it and makes the tag. So one away here in the top of the seventh. That'll bring up Riley Barnes now to bat for Booneville. First pitch in there for a call, strike one. Strike two, called on Barnes. Hutchins in the windup, here's the pitch. Out off to the right, out of play. No balls, two strikes to Riley Barnes. He was hit by a pitch and hit a line drive to second base his last time up. Hutchins in the windup. Here's the pitch, breaking pitch, called strike three. Got him looking. So two outs here in the top of the seventh. The Aggies lead 6-3. Trey Miller, the leadoff batter, will come back around to bat. And he's 1-for-2, flew out to center field, walked and hit a single to right field his last time up. The score around bunt this one back to Hunter Hutchins. He'll field it, throw to first, and get him, and that'll be the ball game. The 1-3 putout will end it, and the Aggies get to win 6-3. Man, oh man, what a ball game. Your Modern Woodman player of the game, Hunter Hutchins, with a complete seven innings pitched. Struck out four, and he got the win 6-3. So Hunter Hutchins, your Modern Woodman player of the game, a complete seven innings. It's just tough for a starting pitcher to do that. We've got a few that have been able to do it several times this year. Hunter showed out tonight for sure. Faced 28 batters. Struck out four. So Hunter Hutchins, your Modern Woodman player of the game. Next ball game will be Saturday here at Kossuth. I believe it's a 2 o'clock game time. You can go to the website khssports.com to get all that information. So the Aggies get to win 6-3. That series and remained undefeated in division play. So until Saturday, live from Kossuth, Mississippi, I'm Josh Longcar. John, y'all be careful driving out there. We'll see you Saturday, folks. Good night.